British Academy Scotland Awards 2016. Lately it's hard to let you know that I'll never learn. I am explosive and volatile, I'm on the turn. It's time to squirm a back into the wall. My cage is spell is contents on the floor. My grave concerns I can't ignore the past.
Thank you, it's really great award and it means a lot to me.
I'm not sure he is an editor, he looks quite normal.
Genuinely, this country punches way above its weight in terms of film and TV composers.
This is incredible. Thank you very much, BAFTA Scotland. It's an honour to be here.
We take the awards, we take the accolades, or in my case, we meet the Jakeys in Sucky Hall Street who are pure heavy excited to see you, pal.
We are awesome in acting in Scotland, you know it. McAvoy, Capaldi, I don't need to go through the names.
It's awfully hard to sit and watch pieces and people kind of nipping at your heels, ready to take your work, you know what I'm saying?
This is alright, innit?
Congratulations to all of the nominees tonight who totally deserve to be signed up here as well. It's a real privilege to be here.
I hope you all feel welcomed into this sort of community.
Danny Boyle!
Back in Scotland, because we're here making a new film, T2. I passed myself off as a Scotsman for about 4 years. I got away with it. And the winner of the Best New Work, Chris Kubik, for Dipper from the Water of Leith. They'll all be transfixed by a great story, and they're yours to tell that story to. I'm never gonna sleep again.
Let's escape from this world.
Should I buy you some new pants?
I can buy more pants.
Change isn't really that bad. It's good.
Don't patronise Miss Peniel with respect.
Bonnie Scotlander.
Right, Bonnie Scotland, right off.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome your host for the evening, Edith Bowman.
Gentlemen, so much to anticipate in that glimpse of the future, and some great BAFTA Scotland events coming up as well with Alan Cumming, Jed Mercurio, and Mrs. Brown's Boys. But here and now, it is my absolute privilege to welcome you all to this annual celebration of creativity as we pay tribute to Scotland's screen industries from a glittering Glasgow. And a special pleasure to say hello to all of our viewers who are watching tonight's event online. So I can see that we have a room pretty packed, full of enormous talent. And can we just ask politely that all of our guests, and particularly those with well-kent faces, are allowed to enjoy the party in peace, without mobile phones being pointed and people going selfie daft. I will personally evict anyone I see with a bloody selfie stick. Just a word of warning. It's been quite a year, a referendum result no one could have predicted, a new Prime Minister no one expected or wanted. And now, of course, we are just days away from possibly the biggest confrontation which could affect every corner of the globe. The one that's going to have an impact on how we look at the world for years to come. But I am confident that Gordon Strachan and the boys can pull off a result. Come on! And so to the ongoing story, or should I say saga, of Scotland's film studio, which we return to every year. It may well be up for nomination for factual series next year. Developments remain hot news, with not one but three proposals. Groundwork for the enhancement to Ward Park in Cumbernauld, where Outlander is filmed, are due to commence next year. A new build facility south of Edinburgh is at an advanced stage of planning consideration, with another near Dundee that would major on the city's world-beating games expertise. Let's hope that all three plans progress, don't we? Yes, please. So that Scotland can continue to be a key destination for international productions. Projections of a record production spend of around £46 million is expected, which coincidentally is exactly how much Ford Kiernan and Greg Hempel are expecting to make from the next Still Game Live show. Tonight we have the chance to celebrate our creative strength and show how much we have to offer. World-class talent and crews, excellent facilities, unbeatable locations, which together mean that so many great TV shows are being made in Scotland. With shows in several categories tonight, the BBC hits keep coming, and at BBC Alba, where Yorpa delivers a nomination again, Cathy MacDonald met Diana Gabaldon, the multi-million selling author of the Outlander novels, to discuss how Scottish history, provided the inspiration for the chronicles in Caledonia TV's Sarscoil Outlander. For those who don't have the Gaelic, that is epic tale, and it definitely is that. Channel 4 and Film 4 continue to invest and commission from Scotland's indie production sector, with record spend on original television commissions for a fourth year in a row. Film 4 continues to invest in feature film out of Scotland, with, of course, the headline being the long-awaited T2 coming in January 2017. I've watched the trailer 85 times. It's brilliant. All four games based in Glasgow have delivered a string of critically and commercially successful mobile game launches, including the Super ArcLight, produced by No Code. Their creative director, John McKellen, has been recognised by BAFTA as one of their breakthrough Brits for 2016. The importance of character creation through the wonders of hair and makeup is being honoured tonight. Our first special award will celebrate acclaimed makeup designer Christine Kant, who's played an integral part in creating some of the best-loved comedy characters of our time, from Alan Partridge to Father Ted's Mrs. Doyle and Death in Horrible Histories. Now, some people say only Christine can make Death look such an attractive proposition, but they obviously didn't sit through Don Coote's acceptance speech last year. Oh, come on. I'm just saying what you're all thinking at the time. Tonight's outstanding contribution to film goes to a unique and esteemed company and the hugely admired trio who collaborate as 16 films. They recently... Yeah. They recently won their second Palme d'Or for the absolutely outstanding I, Daniel Blake. As you'll hear later, many people are deeply grateful to be part of their team and many consider them family. We recognise the work and their continued support of the Scottish industry, crew and actors. The incomparable writer, producer and director, Paul Laverty, Rebecca O'Brien and Mr Ken Loach. This is a room literally bursting with remarkable talent. Now, before we crack on and hand out these trophies, let me just explain our familiar and very simple system, which for the most part worked last year. So please don't let me down, please. Now, we want to hear your speeches. Of course we do, but within reason. So, Yellow card is a caution. Red card means you're off. Which, if I'm right, I didn't have to deliver one of these last year, so let's keep it that way. Good luck to everybody tonight. Let's start then with the award for Best Animation. And talk about a fanfare. What a stellar couple we have to present it. Both multi-award winners themselves, thanks to their work in a show made right here that's won fans all over the world, some of whom I believe are watching us right now. It's a bit freaky, isn't it? Watching us right now on the World Wide Web. Big up yourself, the Hooligans. There's a few of them. They're quite scary and intimidating. In Outlander, they are Jamie Fraser and his time-travelling wife, Claire, but tonight they are the fabulous Sam Heughan and Katrina Balfe.
I've got these, Edith. Thank you very much. Keep them handy.
Hello. Ever since the late, great Norman Maclaren's pioneering work in the 1940s, Scotland has excelled in the field of animation.
Scotland has been the inspiration for blockbusters like Disney's Brave and produces homegrown talent of its own that's right up there with the best.
From Will Anderson and Ainsley Henderson's multi-award-winning shorts to the commercially successful work of the international studios like Axis Animation, producing work here, right here in Glasgow, for video game hits Assassin's Creed and Halo.
There's always a high quality of work to admire, and this year is no different. So let's get on with this and take a look at the nominees.
Animation. American Dream.
This is Samantha's school. It's so close, she can walk by herself and there aren't any fences. Her favorite part is the library because it never runs out of the best books. Every day after school, she goes to the park with her best friends. She's really good at the monkey bars.
No Place Like Home. Testament of Gideon Mack.
The legend is true, isn't it? You are the devil.
Yes, that's who I must be.
Prove it.
And so the devil heals his broken leg with supernatural fire. He confesses to making the stone appear, amongst other things. And before he sends Gideon back, they make plans.
Let's have an adventure, Gideon. Let's escape from this world.
The devil agrees to meet again in Ben Alder. And then he knocks Gideon out and steals his boots.
And the winner is...
The BAFTA Scotland Award goes to No Place Like Home.
Elsa Williams, Anya Woods, Sharna Rothwell, Hazel Ischinska, Michael Hughes, Runjish, Michael, my cinematographer, Jamie Fraser, my composer David McGregor, and with the support of Neil Jack, Cam Fraser, Anna Thompson from Colette, everyone at SFTM, Creative Scotland and BFI, thank you very much.
Thank you.
You don't need me need to tell you that the spectacular growth of the games industry is one of the great success stories in Scotland's creative sector. Our next category recognises the new work that's keeping that tradition alive and clicking. The vibrancy of the industry is reflected in the innovation and calibre of finalists selected for 2016, which comes from small studios. To present, a woman who's helped put Murderous Machines back where they belong on primetime BBC Two, and a pop star who swapped his mic for a milk churn in front of one of tonight's nominations for Best Children's Programme. From Robot Wars and Down on the Farm, please welcome Angela Scanlon and JB Gill.
Good evening, BAFTA Scotland.
How's everyone doing?
Yeah!
You hungry yet? Okay, let's get on with the nominees.
Game, sponsored by Oracle Academy. Binaries. Oh. Glitch Space. Killbox.
And the winner is Glitch Space.
First of all, I want to thank the rest of the team, Robin, Kaylee, Miss, everyone who worked on the game at any point or helped get it to where it is today. I don't know. I don't really have anything else.
What he said.
Yeah. Thank you so much.
Best Current Affairs. To present it, a screen couple whose affair is still very much gripping loyal viewers of River City, pausing only to ask, how could she do that to AJ? Oh my God. Please welcome the wonderful Dawn Steele and Jordan Young.
Sorry, Sanj. Where are you?
Sanj, I'm no.
Hi.
I'm no bothered.
Thank you for having us. It's really lovely to be here.
It is. Current affairs, we're very current and we're having an affair. On the telly.
And let's have a look at the nominees.
Current affairs. BBC Scotland investigates. Britain's puppy dealers exposed.
I'm totally unprepared for what I find inside. These boxes are filled with dogs.
Some of them are about to give birth, some of them have just given birth. There's one here. I cannot tell you how fresh these dogs are. They are this big.
Ben never regained consciousness. He died later in hospital.
BBC Scotland investigates. Rugby and the brain tackling the truth.
The result of multiple concussions in the same game.
It's horrible to watch.
Yeah. Yeah. To think about it, if you had a blood injury, you'd have been removed. Yet with a brain injury, he's kept on. The best thing, he could have been split open. He had been taken off, at least.
Or broken his leg.
Yeah.
Terrible.
Yeah. Terrible.
Eorpa.
I was never ashamed of my son. I wasn't ashamed that I was pregnant, and I wasn't ashamed I fell in love with his daddy. I was afraid. I was afraid of the nuns. I was afraid of priests. I was afraid of policemen. And I was terrified of my father.
And the BAFTA Scotland Award goes to BBC Scotland Investigates Britain's Puppy Dealers Exposed.
I'll just say a few words and then I'll pass you on to the real talent. Thank you very much, BAFTA, first of all, for this award. This, I have to say, wasn't the easiest film to make, but for me, it was one of the most satisfying. Who would have thought that a film about puppies could have had so much of an impact? I just want to say thank you very quickly to the production team who worked on this programme, especially Sandeep Gill, the assistant producer, Sam Poling, who you'll hear from in a second, and also BBC Scotland, who consistently back investigative journalism and brave investigative journalism. And I also want to pay tribute to my fellow nominees as well, who were nominated in this category, such a strong category, and especially to the Investigations Unit at BBC Scotland. As a small unit, we seem to be able to knock out these, you know, investigations films that have real impact. So thank you very much.
Well done, the dogs. That's just very quickly, Liam is the best producer director I have ever had the privilege to work with, other than the other one that's sitting over there, Stephen. Need to cover all bases here. Listen, those who know the backstory to this film, don't worry, I'm not going to go into it. This film was made literally with blood, sweat, and tears on a few occasions. It's a nice subject, cute puppies. It's a horrible, horrible, horrible film to make. It came with very personal consequences to me. So from a very personal point of view, I'd like to thank the BBC for their support. On a few occasions, Kenny Macquarie, Donalda McKinnon, D.I. Brown, Gary Smith, Daniel Maxwell, who were there when we needed them, when I personally needed them. Matt Arundel, who kept me safe in the dark in that clip that you saw and throughout the entire film. He was with me every mile that I drove, every puppy dealer that we filmed, so thank you very much. And BAFTA, thank you very much. It's an honour, thank you.
Just on a side note, Dawn has promised to sing later. You said that earlier. I'm holding you to that. Next up is Factual Series to announce the winner. An outstanding actor and creative talent who's in contention for one of tonight's awards himself as his alter ego, Gary, Tank Commander. That's brilliant. And with him, yes, hush please, ladies and gentlemen, thank you. One of them, the greatest names of Scottish factual broadcasting. Please welcome Greg McHugh and Shireen Nanjiani.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen.
I'm disappointed. Gary's not here tonight. You said he was coming.
I bet, isn't he?
Are we just going to look at the nominations then?
I think so.
Factual Series, sponsored by Deloitte. Into the Wild with Gordon Buchanan.
Oh, that's a reply.
Very cool.
Do you want to give it a go?
What do I do?
Just try and make that noise. That's appalling.
Scotland's Home Movies. Memories on film.
Mum died of a complication of lung cancer when I was only 15. I remember her as being very full of life. She was the one who wanted to party all the time, for the want of a better phrase. Dad brought us up, gave up a lot of his life for us, I suppose. I'm sure he would have liked to live his life out with his wife and retire as anybody else did and, you know, grow old, but that wasn't to be.
This farming life.
Wait till I cast her.
Jumbo was particularly large.
Over the wall.
Wait a second.
He was stuck in the birth canal for too long.
Fat legs!
Yes, breathing.
And the stress nearly killed him.
Is it?
Yeah.
After 8 long minutes, Martin managed to get Jumbo to breathe.
And the BAFTA Scotland Award goes to This Farming Life. Who'd have thought a farming couple from the northeast of Scotland, Aberdeenshire, would be here tonight? We're totally starstruck and thrilled and honoured to be here. We're collecting this award on the behalf of the BBC production, and I'm so glad I've got it because I think they made an amazing job. And on the behalf of myself, Mel, and the other families involved, the McPhersons, the Lennoxes, the Granvilles and the Scots, we'd like to thank the BBC because I don't think they realise the impact that this farming life had on the general public and the great advertising it's done for Scottish agriculture. So thank you.
Stories of the autumn has been the spectacular impact of Still Game on BBC One, not just in Scotland but across the network. If that suggests these are heady days for Scottish productions in the business of making audiences laugh, this year's nominees in the comedy and entertainment category confirm it's the case. Presenting the award, an international comedy star who's made a brilliant return to British sitcom in Channel 4's Catastrophe, alongside a co-star from that show who also found time this year to help with the reboot of Porridge to huge critical acclaim, plus a series commission. Please welcome Ashley Jensen and Mark Bonner.
Evening.
Good evening. I must admit, I feel a wee bit naughty being here tonight, because we're filming at like 11 o'clock in London tomorrow. It feels a wee bit weird.
Ashley's under strict instructions not to drink too much because she's got to punch me in the face tomorrow.
Wee spoiler alert there, Mark.
Shall we take a look at the nominations?
comedy, entertainment. Mrs. Brown's Boys, Christmas Special 2015.
Oh, good God, Grandad! I'm fine, really, I'm okay.
Can't touch this.
Scott Squad.
Okay, that's it. Oh no, it's something. That's better. Okay, Jane, how did you delete on this? I took one of those thumbs up to bigotry, which we don't want. What? The left? What do I send? Jane, I've just sent the thumbs up to bigotry to. I've copied in everyone. I've copied in Sturgeon.
Two doors down.
It's a bowl of peppermints and a selection of Johnny bags.
For God's sake.
And yes, I would like a fresh orange juice.
And the BAFTA Scotland Award goes to Mrs. Brown's Boys Christmas Special.
Making this program here. We're so grateful. Thank you very much indeed. Thank you.
Really nearly had the red card there, just waiting, just in case. What's the opposite of that? It was so quick. Now to single documentary, a category in which Scotland has an incredibly rich tradition. To present it, someone who knows a thing or two about winning awards. After all, he has an Oscar competing for space on a very crowded mantelpiece, which also features trophies from BAFTA Scotland. Still, if anyone can find room, it must be him, because he knows that space is relative, as is indeed time and distance. Doctor in the house, please welcome Peter Capaldi.
Thank you. Lovely to see so many cheery faces out there. Fortunately, everybody can't be cheery to the end of the night. That's the thing with award ceremonies, you know, the room generally fills up with losers. And I know that because I'm usually one of them. Okay, documentary film. Documentary film is probably the greatest tool that we have for empathizing and understanding each other. And in these very troubled and uncertain times, it's never been more important. And the nominations for this award are all hugely worthy of that responsibility. Let's have a look at them.
Single documentary. Dunblane, our story.
Several people have been injured after a shooting incident at Dunblane Primary School.
I think I'm more prone to calling it the shootings. Probably because I was shot.
The islands and the wheels.
Det här borde ganska vara bara mätet resten av klubben.
Vi lytter så deres fire, vi lytter ikke nær nok noen industri i London og så. Hvis jeg akkurat skal gjøre dalk, ja du, da er det øyelig en dags den.
To lonely people, we were strangers in the day.
Seven songs for a long life.
Moment when we said our first hello.
Little did we know,
love was just
a glance away,
a love embracing dance away.
Oh, God, understand.
Ever since that day, we've been together, lovers at first sight, in love forever. It turned out so.
The BAFTA Scotland Award goes to Dunblane Alstair.
Up, I'm truly honoured, I really am. I want to thank the Dunblane community and the people who were in it, they were amazing. I'll probably get quite teary, I guess. This means a lot for them and it means a lot for me. It means a lot for the wonderful crew that worked together and the execs, Ewan Angus and Claire Patterson. Thanks for believing us in the film. And Mick and Stephen McGinty. Stephen McGinty, it was his idea. Oh, yeah. So thank you very much. And if I can, I'd also try and do a special wee thank you for my wife, because she's put up with me for 24 years. I've been making docs for maybe 21 years. And through making this, I probably had a lot of anxiety whether we were doing the right thing making a film. So I'm going to say this is for Dunblane and the people and for Carol and my wife. Thank you very much.
Producers have really made their mark in children's television in recent times, with BAFTA Scotland winners like The Dog Ate My Homework and Katie Morag. To find out which of tonight's nominees will be joining them, we are joined by the magically gifted comedian and star of The Dog Ate My Homework, alongside a presenter who went wild this summer joining the team on Animal Park. Here they are. Please give them a huge round of applause.
Looking gorgeous, aren't you?
Yeah, you're looking lovely, and don't worry, we don't know who we are either. I mean,
I'm Jean Johansson, by the way, and you are?
I don't, no one cares. Literally no one cares. Edith didn't even read my name off the autocue. Anyway, just shows you how appreciated children's television is in the television community. So, genuinely, people that work on kids' TV maybe aren't viewed as much by their counterparts. I don't know if that's an example or not, but they do it genuinely for the passion and for the love. And I'm incredibly proud to be a children's television presenter.
Yes.
And I'm incredibly proud of children's television.
Yes.
So let's have a look at some amazing nominations.
Children's programme. All over the workplace.
Yes, I think we should be told what to do.
When I was your age, and someone told me not to do something, that usually meant I tried to do it.
Maybe you weren't educated properly enough about how to
work. Many people have said that. Now, you two clearly feel quite strongly about this, and you've obviously thought it through as well, but why should adults listen to what 10-year-olds say?
Don't patronise me, Mr. Neil, with respect. We've done our research.
Hello, I'm JB and welcome to Sunday.
Down on the Farm.
Today, we're learning about cows and also a clever use of my favourite fruit, But can you guess what the fruit is? It's ruby red in colour and also makes a very popular ice cream. That's right, it's strawberries. Coming up, Storm and some young friends visit the Royal Highland Show. We meet Zara and Rory, who harvest seaweed. I find out what Farmer Charlie makes with his strawberries. But first, Storm learns how cows are milked.
Life babble.
Change is pretty normal, but that doesn't mean it's always the easiest thing to deal with.
Recently this year, my parents became foster parents, so I now have a new foster sister.
My parents separated, I moved house and country, and at first it was really difficult.
Having someone else living in the house did start to worry me a little bit at first.
And there were days where I was really angry, and some days I was really upset, and sometimes I was just really nervous because I had no idea what these new changes were going to bring into my life.
But as time's gone on, I've started to get used to it, and it's just become normal.
Turns out I worried for nothing, brought all these amazing people into my life.
Whether your family is changing or anything else, it's natural to be nervous.
I guess change isn't really that bad. It's good.
And the BAFTA Scotland Award goes to All Over the Workplace.
Thank you very much indeed. As Ian said, you know, kids' TV, we often get overlooked, but it's just great to be here in this room with all these talented people and to see what a couple of 10-year-old girls can do to Andrew Neil. So I'd like to say a big thank you. Like every other form of television, kids' television is very collaborative, and this wouldn't have happened without an absolutely fantastic team, which we had at CBBC Scotland to do this. Also, I don't know how many of you know Paul Heinemann, but I'd just like to say Paul sadly died last year. He kicked off the project and we then picked up the baton and ran with it. So, Paul, this is for you. Also, a big thank you to Val, who directed. Anybody that can handle Alistair Campbell, Andrew Neil, Disco Dave Cameron, and the Speaker of the House of Commons in the same week has got to be doing something right. And also to Alex, our presenter, who has to wrangle these young kids who can be cheeky, funny, ludicrous, and many other things besides. Thanks, Alex. To Yvonne, my exec, and everybody at CBBC for giving us the chance. Thanks also to BAFTA Scotland for everything, including this evening. But most of all, thanks to the forces of nature that were Charlotte and Henrietta.
Presenting the BAFTA Scotland Awards to All Over the Workplace. We come now to features and factual entertainment, a category where sheer quality is matched by range and breadth. Happily, that's a description which unquestionably matches our next presenters. One, toilet break? One is an acclaimed actor in drama and comedy, a writer and documentary maker. The other, an unflappable presenter who spent this summer bringing all the sunshine of Rio to our screens. Please welcome Sanjeev Kohli and Hazel Irvin.
Good evening, good evening. I'm Sanjeev Kohli.
And I'm a toilet break.
Thank you. Now, before we go ahead with this award, ladies and gentlemen, I would first of all like you to raise the roof for a certain
Andy Murray, who today... has become the first Scot and the first British tennis player ever to ascend to world number one since the world rankings were introduced in 1973. And just to praise you this year, which makes him a shoo-in, surely, for Sports Personality of the Year Award for the third time. He's made 11 of the 12 finals in the events that he's actually entered and won 8 and counting. He's in the Paris Masters final tomorrow. And Alistair Brownlee of triathlon fame is spitting tacks because until that, he was the favourite for Spotty. So go, Andy. Anyway, there's some facts for you. It is the factual award after all. But shall we see the nominations for the real thing now, please?
Features, factual entertainment. Antiques Road Trip.
Isn't that gorgeous?
That is gorgeous.
Surrey's own Catherine is an auctioneer and a road trip regular.
Do I buy the brooch? I do buy the brooch.
But she's particularly pumped up about this one.
Hello. Hey, he was nice. Should we turn round?
Catherine.
Auctioneer Paul from Carlisle, via Scotland, is another tripper with many miles on the clock.
Love this stuff.
What will you do if Donald Trump gets into power? Will you deal with him or dingy him?
Gary Tank Commander, election special.
I think America will dingy him before I do.
Dingy.
Would you?
Categoric dingy. Yeah, I've said that already on the telly. The guy's an arse.
Would you answer, would you pick up the phone and then he'd say stuff and you'd refuse to speak to him?
Like, cheery bye.
I'd like to dingy him before he got into power.
But would you have
would
to you? Deal with him though? If Scotland went
would
independent?
Would you think he's here? Do you like his hair?
I think it reminds me of Dougie Donnelly.
Super Shoppers.
Let's have a look.
Any diamonds?
No.
There's no diamonds?
No.
I'm absolutely gutted. So I don't need to get this insured?
Well, it would have been advisable to have done that before we started working on it.
I see what you mean. Mm. I do see what you mean.
So, it's less diamonds are forever and more diamonds are never.
Now, before I award the winner of this, can I just make an appeal to the winner of this? Don't be Scottish about it. When people win an award, they say, I give it to my mum, I put it in the toilet, I parcel tape it to the dog. Don't do that. Use this award. Do what I do. I take it to auditions. I put it on the table, and they say, so you can fence and speak Spanish? And I say, just check the BAFTA, mate. Or just take it to Marks and Spencer's and return shit you didn't even buy there. And the BAFTA Scotland Award goes to Super Shopper.
It's brilliant to watch. It's really hard to make. We've got a fantastic team who make it brilliant, from our journalists, writers, camera people, editors, directors, everybody else on the team. It's been a brilliant year for Firecrest Films, for Little Firecrest Films, and this is the icing on the cake. This is really lovely. Thank you to Channel 4 and to Dorothy Byrne, our commissioner, but to Channel 4 for their fantastic support this year. This is a real surprise and a real joy. Thank you very much.
Why then, Peter Mullen, David Tennant, and Ken Stott.
are among the recent winners in our next category, which honours the best actor on television in the past year. And I don't mind telling you, there are some big guns in the running. To present the award, one of the most in-demand actresses of today, we're not breaking that poor vicar's heart in Grantchester, she's breaking our hearts in the A word. Please welcome the beauty and talent that is Morven Christie.
Evening. With a time-travelling doctor, an island detective, and the Laird of Lallybroch all battling it out in the category of actor television, I'm sure you'll agree we're all spoilt for choice this year. They are all, I'm sure you'll agree, outstanding performances. Let's have a look at the nominees.
Actor Television, sponsored by the Corinthian Club. Peter Capaldi, Doctor Who.
Yes.
But we need to concentrate.
Yes, it is.
Yeah, I know where you're going with this, but I need you to calm down.
On the outside?
Oh, you certainly grasp the essentials.
My entire understanding of physical space has been transformed! Three-dimensional Euclidean geometry has been torn up, thrown air, and snapped to death. My grasp of the universal constants of physical reality has been changed. Sorry. I've always wanted to see that done properly.
Douglas Henshaw, Shetland.
Something happened very recently at work. And it's not my story. I'm just a bystander. But it's about how men are with women. And I've been struggling with it. I'm struggling with it. And I don't want it to intrude. And so that's what last night was about. And not about anything else. And not about you. And really, really not about you.
Sam Hume, Outlander.
Today is ours. Saturday. The British are routed. General Cope is in retreat, leaving hundreds of dead and wounded behind.
And our losses can't number more than 50 men. A whole thing took all of 15 minutes.
If only we had cavalry. We could have pursued the enemy, captured General Cook, perhaps put an end to the rebellion this very morning.
And the BAFTA Scotland Award goes to Douglas Henshaw for Shetland.
Thank you very much. That's a surprise. I'd like to thank BAFTA Scotland, and I'd like to thank everybody involved with Shetland, from our runners all the way up to our producers. We are one big, happily dysfunctional family in Shetland, and I wouldn't have them any other way. I'd specifically like to thank Elaine Collins. She's been the architect and the driving force behind this since day one, and she's been relentless about trying to make us the best show that she possibly can. I take my hat off to her, and I'll miss her next year when she's not here. Also, our script supervisor, Claire Batty, for the same reasons. Our writers, especially on last season, Gabby Chappie, David Kane, Robert Murphy, without whom none of us would have anything to do. Our producer and line producer, Eric Coulthard and Mark Murdoch, and all our principal cast, and I'm not going to mention them all because I know there's a couple of names I'm just going to forget. However, if you've been in this industry for the last 25 or 30 years, you would have come across a grip by the name of Ian Johnston. And he very sadly died while we were making the first proper series a Shetland when we were on the islands. And I'm not going to claim that he and I were great friends, but I worked with him many times over the years, and every time that I walked onto a set and I saw him, I was happy to see him because he was good at his job. And also you knew that if things were going badly and you were stuck in some godforsaken hillside at 3 o'clock in the morning in the rain, having a bitch and a cigarette, you knew that at least you'd be funny about it. I think about him every single time we go back to Shetland, and the industry is all the poorer for his loss. And I'd like to dedicate this to him, Dean Johnson.
Tonight's next award is for the best piece of specialist factual television. Arts, science, history, you get the idea. To announce the winner, we thought perhaps a writer or successful presenter might be an idea, or a producer, or a long and distinguished, one with a long and distinguished track record, or maybe an art historian with authority and expertise to burn. Luckily, they all answer to the name of Muriel Gray.
Thank you very much, Edith. What a gorgeous and completely lovely night. I think we should cherish this night, because if Donald Trump wins in 2 days' time, next year's BAFTAs will be coming from a hollowed-out ice cave in Spitsbergen. There'll be one category. It'll be survivors. Mrs. Brown's boys will still win, though. Specialist factual. I spat there. This is a... I'm catching on things in a spat. This is a very, very honourable category. Let's see who the lucky nominees are this year.
Specialist Factual. Imagine Richard Flanagan, life after death.
People worry about how their hair looks, or what other people think of the colour they've painted their house. Or, as I was once asked by a woman, what size doily to put on her washing machine. But you will understand me when I say that if you are drowning, none of these things seem overly important. And I am drowning.
Ted Hughes, Stronger Than Death.
Poetry is a means of transforming experience.
He was extraordinarily striking. And the first person you thought of when you saw Ted Hughes was Heathcliff. He was a man who radiated artistic power.
More controversy and scandal attaches to his name than that of any other figure in literature, with the exception of Lord Byron.
The truth about dementia.
Is that her birthday kiss?
Happy birthday, kid.
That's it, your birthday, aren't I? Did I get you a present?
No.
Didn't I?
For Ida's birthday, I'm going to look after Bob while she goes to get her nails done. And despite recovering from a broken leg, she's determined to make her own way there.
Just make sure he has a drink every hour.
Will do.
Thank you, darling.
Yep.
I can't imagine you cooking, you know.
Why not?
Oh, you're a glamour girl, aren't you?
Sure. No. Of course I cook.
And the BAFTA Scotland 2016 award goes to Imagine.
Thank you very much, BAFTA. You shouldn't really name drop. That's a lesson I learned from Alan Yentob, actually. And it's, I think it's one that he picked up from Bono, in fact. Or it might have been Sting, I can't remember. But if you'll permit me, I will drop a few names this evening by way of thank you. First of all, I'd like to thank my wife, Susie, for her patience. Oh, and a round of applause for her patience and understanding. Secondly, I'd like to thank my other wife, editor, Dave Arthur, should be standing up here beside me, but unfortunately has some wisdom tooth issues at the moment. I'd like to thank everyone at Sirius. Yes, I knew that would get a cheer. And the whole production team, Lucy, Fran, Jackie, Tanya, and of course, Uncle Alan. But most of all, I would like to thank Richard Flanagan. Spending time with him making this film was a real privilege for me, and I'm very proud to call him my friend. He's the sort of man that I aspire to be, and his kindness, generosity, and wisdom have helped me through a very difficult year personally. So really the prize, the award, is his friendship, but this is pretty lovely too. So thank you very much.
Let you know that we are past the halfway mark. Not exactly on the finishing straight yet, but we've turned the corner for home. Hang in there, we can do this together. If anybody else wants to get up and walk around, feel free. Anyone? Anyone else? There we go. And hush. Thank you. Our next award is for this year's best short film. To present it, a rising actor seen this year on television in War and Peace and on film in Tommy's Honour. Soon, he'll also add to his credit playing Tony Benn in A United Kingdom, which is a phenomenal film, and also in Christopher Nolan's epic Dunkirk. Please welcome Jack Lydon.
Good evening, how you doing? I used to live around the corner when I was here at drama school, and we used to use this place, we'll try and use this place to have a pee on the way back from a night out and get told to leave quite quickly. So I spent that whole champagne reception just going back and forth to the toilet. Not because I needed a pee, you know, just because I could. Anyway, patter. Making your first short film is no mean feat, but if you make a great one, it can become a calling card for any filmmaker at the beginning of their career. And tonight's three nominees certainly fall into that category. So let's take a look at them.
Short film. Isabella.
I can still remember that very vividly. She, I mean, she didn't hit me or do anything other than snigger and laugh and think this is a great joke. But one day, she did it once too often. And I turned on her. I just took her by the shoulder and shook her. And of course, I was at her wall at the time, and I bumped her head off the wall. And I enjoyed it.
Swan.
I feel frightened about her growing up and being an adult, because I mean, she's getting older, and it means I'm getting older. I'm very aware that, you know, life, we all die at some point, and I just want to make sure that she's okay before my time's up.
Take your partners.
Which silly sausage forgot their lunchbox?
You. Here you go. Have you
been cool, guys? All right, you lot. Fast and quick. See you later.
And the BAFTA Scotland Award goes to Isabella.
I feel a bit ill.
I feel pretty nervous, actually. Should we do some thanks as well?
Thanks very much to Ross for putting up with me.
Thanks for being involved.
Thanks to Creative Scotland.
Aye, that's
who funded us for the short, and to Keith,
Robbie.
And Robbie Will, and Will.
Will was in there.
thanks very much.
Aye. No, like, you should say thanks to Isabella, really.
And to your gran.
She was pretty big.
She is it.
She is it. It's really a film. It's like, it means a huge amount, I should say, actually. It's massive. But the film is like for her, really. It means a massive amount. Thanks so much, BAFTA Scotland.
Thanks very much to BAFTA as well. Yeah,
cheers. Yes. Have a good night. Yeah.
Up for comedy duo next year. Time now for the award for Best Writer in Film and Television. Now, you might think that finding a presenter to match the stature of such a prestigious award might be what Sherlock Holmes called a two-pipe problem, or what a writer of my acquaintance called a two-bottle problem. But it's a problem we've managed to solve in fine style. Please welcome one of the giants of modern television writing, the co-creator of Sherlock, Stephen Moffat.
A lot of people will tell you that the only really important thing in a fictional television programme is the script. The vast majority of those people, it must be said, are writers. Those of you who are directors and producers and actors may think your jobs are also important. I mean, no offence, but we basically write it all down for you, right? I'm not really getting the fuss. I mean, it's like, we did the homework and you copied it, yeah? And then you go on interviews and claim you made it up. Well, you didn't sodding well make it up, we made it up. And just because we're less attractive and socially accomplished, it shouldn't be held against us. Three people who I'm sure are deeply socially accomplished and slightly offended at the moment are here.
Writer, film, television, sponsored by Creative Scotland. Gabby Chiappi, Shetland.
Do you know how far you drove?
I could have been going in circles. I couldn't see.
Right, when you got to the place inside, could you hear anything? Nothing like a road or a railway or...
Myself. I could hear myself. Pathetic.
I don't know, it's sort of left.
DC Moore, not safe for work.
Which as I get older, I've been sort of falling into faster and faster, and yesterday I sort of crashed. I ended up in hospital, and when I woke up and it like all came together in my head, I had this moment of like...
clarity.
Yeah.
Jonathan Wilson and Kira Conway, River City.
The damage is too severe. He can't survive on his own.
No.
Even like this.
No, Max, no.
We have to let him go, Kel. For his own sake.
No. I've only just met him.
I'm so sorry.
To the two people, to the people who are not about to win, top three is amazing. Don't ever forget it. First among winners is DC Moore.
Sorry for everything since 1707, but particularly everything since June of this year. Don't leave us, but we'll understand if you do. All I want to say really is thank you to Glasgow, where we filmed, Channel 4, who made it, Clark and Will helped us make it as well, and my wife, Bea. Thank you very much. Cheers.
We've reached the first of this year's special awards. It honours an outstanding contribution to craft and is presented in memory of the internationally renowned makeup artist Robert McCann. To sing the praises of this year's recipient, here's a broadcaster whose own remarkable career has been honoured in full measure by BAFTA Scotland. I like to think of her as the slim to my fat boy, as we tore up the dance floor DJing 2 years ago at this very ceremony, Kirsty Wolf.
As she says herself when she's making someone up, Christine Kant goes for the essence of their character. She's played an integral part in realizing the look for some of our best-loved comedy characters, the mildly certifiable Mrs. Doyle and Father Ted, to the spirit of jazz and the Mighty Boosh, to Jennifer Saunders' Talksbooth show host Vivian Vile. Her comedy catalogue is packed full with other exceptional shows, like Jeeves and Wooster, Spaced, Alan Partridge, Rock Profile, Harry and Paul's Story of the Two S's, the IT Crowd, Horrible Histories, and Blandings. And she is equally expert in drama too, winning a BAFTA earlier in her career for Poirot. She has been recently making up murderers in Midsummer after completing Absolutely Fabulous, the movie. She is absolutely fabulous herself, a true artist. She studied painting at Glasgow School of Art, and after a brief period as an art teacher at Lindsay Academy and a medical illustrator, she joined the BBC in the trainee makeup department at BBC Scotland. One of her first makeups as a trainee was the challenge of turning Robbie Coltrane into Lou Grade with a full baldy cap for the comedy sketch show, Do You Remember It Well? A Kick Up the 80s. Her maxim for a good makeup artist is massive improvisation and monumental calm. And I can vouch for that, for having been lucky enough to be made up by her. I know that the next hour or two will be the best time I ever had that day. She's funny, feisty, smart, incredibly rude, witty, and gossipy, and she can spot bullshit at 100 yards. Working in Absolute Fabulous for a very short time was wonderfully chaotic, but Christine never gets herself into a fanco. She has seen it all before. Let's take a look at some of her work.
Outstanding contribution to craft in memory of Robert McCann.
Christine Kant. I'm so sorry I can't be with you there this evening, but as you can see, I'm in Hollywood. Not now, not yet. I'm in Hollywood doing one of my new blockbusting movies. But Christine, I've known you for what? 100 years? And I'll tell you why I enjoy working with you, because not only, and this is for real, you are an incredible creative genius, but you manage to combine that with a level of professionalism that very few of us will ever attain.
Nothing phases you, nothing. I've seen you create a full 18th century wig and beard from nothing but a merkin at your fingertips.
Christine is the boss. She's the Bruce Springsteen of the makeup world. That is her empire. Don't mess with Canty.
She really is excellent at her job. She doesn't take prisoners. She just wants it to be the very best.
Very, very energising presence from the off.
Room for a couple of tiddlers?
Seem to be full up.
Fear not, my friend. Lennox will not harm you.
I mean, I wouldn't draw comparisons with Hitler or Stalin. Oh, would I?
Ooh. So it always happens with Christine. We're never waiting for Christine.
She said it was, it was infantile nonsense, and she'd rather watch Deal or No Deal.
I touched you up a bit while you were asleep. Just a little touche clair.
Hello, everybody.
How do I look?
Fabulous. Thank you.
Nobody but Christine could have made The Mighty Boosh as visually exciting as what it was. It was so unique to itself, and she pulled that off. You know, that it was that was that had her stamp all over it.
Your sweet ass is mine now. Chicka chicka ow. Ow! Man, my hat's on fire. What's wrong with you? Are you blind? Why didn't you tell me?
Sorry, I thought that was your look.
It's quite a precious thing. It's like when you write with someone and you can write with them quite well. You like to get in there and do the grotesques as well.
Stuck to my fingers.
What?
Stuck to my fingers.
Get it off.
I can't, it's hurting.
What?
It's hurting, it's supposed to hurt. Breathe on.
I have absolutely no idea, no recollection whatsoever of when and where I met Christine. But there's no point in asking her because she's so old now, she won't be able to remember it either.
Tonight, we launch a second. What on earth are we going to call it? Pipes in, pencils out.
I think what really makes Christine stand out, like you know, many of her peers are at the top of their game, is that they take no crap from actors.
Put it back! I want my saggy old face back!
You're a piece of clay, something to model and sculpt.
Not a hint of a soggy bottom. What a clever little ordinary person you are. Wouldn't I make a wonderful queen?
And I'm better than you.
Christine and I are stamped from the same cloth, I like to think, and that is we're quite tough.
You look just like your father.
I went into the makeup at one point and said, do you have a lipstick that might suit me? And she went, do you know, I have, and presented me with a small lipstick, which I looked at, put in my bag. The next day she came out from the truck onto the set and she went, have you got your lipstick on? And I went, no. She went, don't know why I bother, and walked off.
You know, people like Elizabeth Taylor. Isn't that right, Elizabeth?
Oi, the King of Pop, Michael Jackson, is one of the most kind, dear, honest people I have ever met. Oi.
See, I'm not mad.
Oh, you're dead funny. You know, I love my job sometimes. I do.
What makes Christine good at her job is that she has the ability to make things that shouldn't be funny, funny. For example, Mrs. Doyle with her monobrow and walsh.
We kind of took great delight in it never being set where the mole was, you know? And it was great that Christine liked that kind of thing because that was really, that was our sense of humour. She was a lovely presence to have around, not just because of the work she did, but because of the influence that she had on the whole production.
They're very hairy hands all together, aren't they?
What do you think is wrong with him?
I don't know.
God, do you remember the time his head went septic?
Congratulations, Christine Kant, or Christine Cantankerous, as I call you sometimes, but not when I'm in the same room as you. In fact, not when I'm in the same country as you, which I'm not. But anyway, I just want to send all my love. And it's been a joy working with you over the years, and here's to another 200 years of makeup and glue.
Many congratulations, Christine. You really deserve it. Well done.
It's fantastic to hear that you're being honoured in this way, and I hope you have a brilliant night.
She's a true one-off. They broke the mould. Thank God they did, and thank God that I was lucky enough to be your trainee. Congratulations, Christine. You're an absolute legend.
If I was there this evening, I would take you by the shoulders and violently shake you to make you realise how much you deserve this. You deserve this even more than the tiny beaker of Sauvignon Blanc in a polystyrene cup that you have at the end of a hard working day. So enjoy, enjoy this evening, please. Spielberg, I'm on my way. He's so funny, he's desperate for me to.
Hello, BAFTA Scotland. Many great things have come out of Scotland. Shortbread, Daft Limmy, The Loch Ness Monster, Ivor Cutler, all my personal favourites. But none quite so great as Christine Kent. Christine, thank you so much for all your work on The Mighty Boosh, Luxury Comedy, The IT Crowd. In fact, I've never attempted to make a show without your genius. You are a visual genius, and we've had some brilliant times together. You're a plucky, fiery character. I remember the time you nearly super glued my eyes shut during The Mighty Boosh, or the time you got me utterly paralytic in front of Steve Coogan and Henry Normal, executive producers on the show, or the time you painted my entire head and body green for The Hitcher in a special new kind of makeup that you'd found that doesn't come off skin. We had some fun, didn't we? In fact, I found the first mask that we ever made together out of chamois leather. So I'm gonna put it on and do a little celebratory dance for you. Congratulations, get going for me.
Ladies and gentlemen, go on, give it up for Christine Kent. She is absolutely fabulous. To get it here in Glasgow, and it's Robert McCann's in his name, you know, he's an old friend of mine, so yeah, that makes it extra special. I've been so lucky to work with people over the years that just have trusted me enough to let me run with what I can do, you know, and just create characters and yeah, have a good time doing it. 35 years later, I'm still having a great time. I've just been so lucky, and I still meet interesting people, funny people. And I get to see lots of really interesting car parks from my makeup truck window. And yeah, I'm so flattered by this. It's just absolutely amazing. And thank you so much.
This time last year, our next presenter was on this very stage to collect the award for outstanding contribution to film and TV. In the 12 months in, he's to be part of the Doughty platoon that stormed the UK box office in Dad's Army, secretly nursed Winston Churchill back to health for ITV, and helped set the Twitterverse afire in the groundbreaking BBC sitcom Fleabag. He's currently filming the third season of Outlander as canny Edinburgh lawyer Ned Gowan. To name and acclaim this year's best television actress, please welcome the 5'7.5" of concentrated brilliance that is Bill Paterson.
Five eight
with the patent shoes on. You know, a spectacular action-packed drama, slightly raunchy with very strong Scottish connections, an expletive-laden comedy, and a compelling soap opera full of extraordinary twists and turns, yes. All the descriptions of the Clinton-Trump melodrama that we're living through at the moment, God bless us and God help us. But it's an apt description of the three categories of work for which we are nominating tonight Best Actress in Television. So let's just have a look at that work.
Actress, television, sponsored by Glenfiddich.
La Vierge va vous réconforter, madame. Elle aussi a perdu un enfant.
Katrina Balfe, Outlander.
Oh, baby. Bring me my baby. Bring me my baby. Bring me my baby. A minute more for living. I want my baby.
Ashley Jensen, Catastrophe.
Some of your stuff got mixed up in there too, so give them a quick kiss.
Thank you.
Some of those boxers look like they've been worn for more than a week.
Well, I don't need you to.
I mean, really, they were grey. And I don't want to embarrass you, but there was brown in there too. It's no way for a grown man to live. Should I buy you some new pants?
I can buy my own pants.
Oh, can you? Who's a big boy?
Annie Wallace, Hollyoaks.
Really? Do you think it's easy going through this kind of change? That I enjoyed being called names and being laughed at by people? Families moving tables in restaurants? Teenagers calling me names? Being told I can't use the ladies' bathroom? Adults sniggering? And children pointing? None of this is fine!
And the winner, Best Actress Television, is Katrina Balfe.
I'm very honoured to get to work with Bill over the last couple of seasons. I have so many people to thank. Ron, Marrell, thanks for taking a chance on someone who'd never been on a TV set before. You took a massive chance on me, and I'll never forget that, so thank you. To Michael, thank you for also having your spidey senses and saying that I should retape for Outlander because he felt that I would be good to do the role. Being in Scotland, we have the most amazing crew. I have this trio of consiglieres. Marnie, my costume, Andy, my driver, and Anita, my hair and makeup, and without those three, you know, my day would never get done. But I'm also very lucky that I have not one, but two amazing husbands on this show. So, Sam, thank you for being the most amazing co-star. You're only as good as your scene partner, so I feel very lucky to have you as a partner every day, and Tobias as well. So, thank you very much. This is amazing, and have a good night.
Right then, our next award goes to the year's Best Director in Film or Television. It's presented by an actress who was honoured by BAFTA Scotland last year for her breakthrough role, thanks Mum, in My Mad Fat Diary, and hasn't looked back since. Seen this year alone in Two Doors Down, Brief Encounters, and now in Zapped. Please welcome the wonderful Sharon Rooney.
Hiya! It's an absolute joy to be back. Thanks, Anna. To be back in Glasgow to present this award. So let's take a look at the nominees.
Director, film, television, sponsored by Tattinger. Michael Keeler, Line of Duty.
Okay, come on, come on!
Douglas McKinnon, Sherlock, The Abominable Bride.
We'll finalise the details tomorrow evening. Now, if you'll excuse me, I'm hanging in Wandsworth, and I'd hate them to start without me.
A hanging?
I take a professional interest. I also play the violin and smoke a pipe. I presume that's not a problem. And you're clearly acclimatised to never getting to the end of a sentence. We'll get along splendidly. Tomorrow evening, 7 o'clock, then. Oh, and the name is Sherlock Holmes, and the address is 221B. Baker Street.
Yes. He's always been like that.
Jan Matisse, Shetland.
How do you like to be called? Alison? Is Alison okay?
Do you want to talk to a police officer, Alison? We're not the police. We're independent. But if you want to talk to someone...
No. No, please.
But you would like us to gather evidence. Is that right?
Would you like somebody with you while we do this, Alison?
And the BAFTA Scotland Award goes to Douglas McKinnon.
Douglas can't be here tonight, as we didn't tell him he'd be nominated for a joke. But that gives me an opportunity to say of my old friend Douglas, he is the most brilliant and the most Scottish man I have ever met. So it is the fact that he is getting a Scottish BAFTA is like getting, is like giving an award to Scottishness itself. Now, I know he would get all sentimental and just talk about me if he were up here, but one of the people I know, and I genuinely mean this, I know that he would thank is sitting here tonight, and that's Paul McGuigan, who began Sherlock and set the visual style and set the bar so high. So I know that that Douglas, honestly, Paul, Douglas would thank you, and then he would say, but I did it better. Do you want to fight? And then you also being Scottish, there would be an actual fight. So I'm kind of personally glad that my great friend Douglas McKinnon, the deserved winner of this award, is not here tonight. Please applaud the most Scottish man you've ever heard of. Thank you.
Best actress in a film. Here to announce the winner is one of the busiest and very brightest screen stars, a man so irresistibly charming and talented that he even managed to look cute with a baldy head in X-Men Apocalypse. Let's make some noise for the one and only Mr. James McAvoy.
I've been told two things. I've been told to speak up because these mics aren't worth shit. And the other thing is to make sure that I take note of the white line. And that's just something I expect to hear in a toilet. So I'm putting the BAFTA on the white line. and I'm not going to duck down to it. Ladies and gentlemen, what am I talking about? Oh dear God. Ladies and gentlemen, good evening. Yes, I know, eh? It is a good evening. The work that has been offered up this year by tonight's nominees, Kate Dickey, Ruth Negga, Alison Peebles for Best Actress has been, and I suppose thanks to the nature of film, will always be, remembered as being amazing. And it makes me very proud to stand here and help celebrate them. So let's have a look at some of their work.
Actress, film, sponsored by MAC Cosmetics. Kate Dickey, Couple in a Hole.
I'm really sorry.
Ruth Negga, Iona.
She came with her boyfriend when she was pregnant with me.
What happened to him?
He went back to Bristol. Mum stayed. She wanted me to be born here.
And she called you Iona? Did she believe in God?
Yes. She did.
Alison Peebles. Where do we go from here?
It was the height of glamour and ready. Matching outfits, hats. Designed by Balenciaga, Pierre Cardin. See the world. Marry a captain. Jet set life. Closest I ever got was cleaning the toilets in the departure lounge.
Good stuff. Here we go. The BAFTA Scotland Award goes to Kate Dickey.
So much to BAFTA and to the jury. This is it's so lovely. I was really honoured to be nominated with Alison, who I've been a fan of forever. She's amazing. And Ruth, who absolutely broke my heart, and Iona, her and Dougie actually. They were amazing in that film. So it was a real honour just to be nominated with them. And thank you. We made a wee mongrel of a film, I call it, because we had Scottish actors, a Belgian director, we had Portuguese, we had French, we had all these nationalities, the way a film should be. So as I say, up you, Brexit, because... about film to do with the, I won't even use the word Brexit actually, I find that word ridiculous, but Britain leaving the EU worries me. So to all the producers and money people and that, please fight hard to make films. Our wee film, I don't know how it got funded. It's about a couple living in a hole called Couple in a Hole. And it was a hard sell. And Colin Birch from Verve, who's a real champion independent film, luckily took us on. And I just want to say a wee thank you to Tom Geens, our wonderful director-writer, who's amazing. Zarana and Aurelie, our producers. Colin from Verve, my lovely partner who puts up with me getting into very dark places. My agent, who I'm like, oh God, I really want to do this film about a couple living in a hole. And she's like, yeah, on you go. So just a few thank yous, really. But the biggest thank you I want to give to is Paul Higgins, my co-star. He should be up here. He is incredible in this movie, and if you watch it for one reason, watch it for him. He was the most beautiful co-star I ever had, and he's a wonderful actor, and I learned a lot from him. So this is for Paul as well. Thank you.
In film to best actor. Presenting the award is the leading man who took away this honour last year thanks to his compelling performance in Kijaki. Thanks again, Mum. Please welcome David Elliott.
Good evening. I was actually quite nervous when I was asked to come and present this award because I worried that it was a bit like one of those football trophies where you have to bring it back so the winner the next year then takes it off you. So when I found out that wasn't the case, I agreed to come. Let's have a look at the nominees this year.
Actor, film, sponsored by Audi, Brian Cox, The Carer.
Please, stop being such an old ham.
There should come to this.
Hmm?
Hiring somebody to care about me.
Caring for you. It's not the same thing. We could never hope to pay anyone to care about you.
Oh. Thank you, Sophia. Always a kind word for your dying father.
Just see her for a few minutes. Talk to her. Is that too much to ask?
Is she a Muslim?
Oh, don't start that again. Of course she's not a Muslim.
Jack Loudon, Tommy's Honour.
Dad, I'm not a child anymore. Can you not see that? I'm a married man now. You can't just keep making decisions for me. I don't need you to do that anymore.
We had to finish the match.
No, we didn't. No, we didn't, Dad. No. There is no shame to a forfeit if you can't play on. Did you not tell me that? Is that not one of the many golden rules that you drummed into me since I was a boy?
We were winning.
No. No, you were having a good game, Dad, and you don't have many of them anymore. Golf is your god, Dad. It's not mine.
I'll see you when I see you then.
Peter Mullen, Hector.
Thank you. Right. Take care of yourself.
Yeah, you too.
I mean it. You look after yourself, yeah?
Yeah, yeah. You look after yourself.
All right. Still. Bye.
And the winner of the BAFTA Scotland Award is Peter Mullen for Hector.
Good evening. You can probably tell from my accent that I'm not Peter Mullen. Peter is in the States filming at the moment. I understand it was an artistic decision and nothing to do with the strength of the dollar. Anyway, He sent me a he has sent me a note to read out just in case this eventuality happened. Are we past the water shape?
Fine, go.
Yep. Okay.
Fine.
Right, okay. Well, I thought I'd talk for Glasgow, it's pretty tame. Okay, this is what Peter says. Firstly, I'd like to congratulate Ken, Paul, and Rebecca on their award for the contribution to world cinema, much deserved. I'd also like to congratulate my fellow nominees, Brian, who's been a hero of mine since I was a teenager, and Jack, who I've been a hero to since he was a child. Many thanks to Jake for giving me the chance to work with such a great cast and crew. Sorry again for not being able to accept this award in person, not least because this fucker will have pawned it by the time I get back. Thank you very much.
Right, time now to reveal the winner of the BAFTA Scotland Award for Best Television Drama. Opening the envelope is a BAFTA-winning actress who we've seen this year getting back into uniform in Line of Duty. Yes. Getting vengeful in The Secret Agent and getting out and about in Glasgow filming The Replacement. Please give her a massive warm welcome. She is awesome. It's Vicky McClure!
Hiya! Thank you very much. Right, Scottish producer... me and Morvin said who's going to mess up and I've done it. I can't read the autocue. Right, Scottish produced drama has never been better and the opportunities in Scotland for actors gets bigger every year. We have three brilliantly contrasting dramas this year and I'm pleased to announce the BAFTA nominees for television drama are...
Television drama. Not safe for work.
I've sort of... crashed a bit, you know. And I just wanted to come home.
You're all right, aren't you?
No, I'm not.
Outlander. Shetland.
There was more of him. You know. Could you please tell Sandy for me? I want him to know.
I'll tell him. I would like to give you a hug. Would that be allowed?
Sorry.
Hey. Lady, you call the shots around here.
Thanks.
Okay, and the BAFTA Scotland Award goes to Shetland.
So I'll be fast. Thank you, BAFTA Scotland. This means a lot. Thanks to Ben Stevenson for commissioning, Chris Aird for being an endless support, my pal and brilliant script exec, Claire Batty. Eric Coulter for producing and being a joy to work with. The brilliant cast and crew led by Dougie and Alison. Dougie is just my ideal Perez. Thank you, Dougie. Thanks to David Kane and Alex Perrin for joining us halfway through. Robert Murphy, who storylined with us and wrote two terrific episodes. And especially Gabby Chappie, who I think wrote an absolutely outstanding episode 5. Thank you to Rape Crisis and the SARC. You do incredible work and your help and advice were invaluable. Getting this right for you was the most important thing to us. So thank you so much for helping us and supporting us. Finally, thank you to the people of Shetland for making us so welcome. And Peter and Sissy, I love you. Tonight's penultimate award yes. Honours the year's best feature film. Yes. To present it, we have a gifted director. Come on now, penultimate. That's the time to be quiet, otherwise it's going to take longer. We have a gifted director whose recent work in the Netflix series Luke Cage is receiving rave reviews. He won a BAFTA Scotland Award for Special Achievement for Television's Sherlock, and he's currently in post-production in Glasgow with the feature Film Stars Don't Die in Liverpool, starring Jamie Bell, Annette Bening, and Julie Walters. With him, this is amazing, the producer of that film, now Vice President Film at BAFTA and a driving force behind the enduring success of the greatest film franchise of all time, bar none. Please welcome Paul McGuigan and Barbara Broccoli.
Thank you very much. The boss has told me I'm speaking tonight, so I apologise. And I'm not the new James Bond, by the way, in case you're wondering. You can do CGI amazing work, but maybe not as good as that. Let's have a look at nominees. Before we do, though, I would love to say that it's amazing that for anyone who is nominated tonight for a film, TV, anything, we all know how hard it is to make a film. And Barbara and I were talking the other day about, because Barbara's been trying to make the film that we're doing just now for 22 years. So if Barbara Broccoli is struggling to get a film made, then you understand how difficult it is. And everyone who's nominated tonight for this particular prize should be so proud of themselves. And it's great that in Scotland we have this amazing talent that's here, and hopefully we'll get more support from the people who should be giving us support to make these films. And everyone talks about a studio. Yes, please just do the studio so that we can get it done. And we can get lots of work here, and so that people like Barbara Broccoli and all the other people are here, the very talented people, will come and work here because it's an amazing place to work. Anyway, enough of that. Let's have a look at these great nominations.
Feature film, sponsored by Cineworld. Moondogs.
So, I'm going to give you my watch.
Thanks very much.
And I'm going to take this.
Right, you are. That will be £4.
No. I'm giving you my watch.
Yes, dear, you've already said that. The toy is £4.
No. I want to swap. Right, so my watch for this piece of crap.
We don't do swaps.
Now listen.
Don't you listen to me.
A good harvest in spite of all things.
Sunset Song.
And the grain a fine price. So farming folk did well. Soon maybe the war would end, and they'd all be back at Carnaddy as once they had been. Longdrob and Chi. And her Ewan.
Tommy's Honour.
Old Mrs. Fraser wouldn't recognise me now.
Oh, the lady that you work for.
Aye, lace making.
She slapped me once for wearing a ribbon in my hair.
If she saw you now, she'd kill you outright.
Okay, and the BAFTA Scotland Award goes to Tommy's Honour.
So good, so good. 5 years to get this film made, and it's a golf movie, but it's not. It's a love story, and it's a tragedy, and it's a beautiful thing, and there is so much talent here, so much talent. Jack. Peter. Ophelia, she's not Scottish, but she's talented. Sam Neill. I mean, I remember I read something, a director talked about what it is to make a film. And he said, and I don't know who the director is, and I'm probably going to misquote it, but he said that it's like, what is it to make a film? And he said, well, it's like arriving every day and the building is burning down and you try and get out the best you can until it burns to the ground every day. And when you do a period movie, it's even harder to get the good stuff out because there's beards and wigs and costumes. And, you know, we had 33 days and we had 50 locations and we had fantastic crew and we had fantastic actors. And every day they ran into the fire and they pulled the best stuff out and they created, I think, a great film. And it's not one person, it's all of us. And to do it, it's a magical thing. And I'm really proud of Jack. Jim, who called me and said, I have a book, Tommy's Honor, Kevin wrote it, his wife and he want to write it, we worked on it together, and he trusted me to do that, Jim Kreutzer. And anyway, thank you. It's a real pleasure. Thank you so much.
Thank you. I bring you greetings from America, where in a few days we may actually elect a reality TV show host. And where most Americans unfortunately think of Brexit as a breakfast cereal. I cannot thank you enough. This was initially my project from the beginning. I apologize to the people that I forget to thank tonight, but they know who they are. Keith Bank, Kent Whitney. The actors were remarkable. And if you think for one moment that this is not a pinch-me experience for all of us that may have been in this business for a while, it truly is. And I take back everything I always said about award ceremonies for film. It is truly an amazing experience. I need to thank my wife, who put up with me for a long time. And as you may know, as men grow older, they sort of lose a little bit of their testosterone and become a little bit more emotional. So thank you so much for this opportunity. And before I start breaking down, I will leave you with that. Thank you so much.
Didn't know where he was going to go with that one, if I'm being honest. Right then, we've reached tonight's final award, which recognises outstanding contribution to film. Here to tell us about the remarkable work and the distinctive outlook of the people BAFTA Scotland honours tonight are two of Scotland's very finest actors. One joins us from filming In the Line of Duty in Belfast, and the other has been appearing in ITV's Friday night thriller, The Level. Please welcome Martin Compston and Gary Lewis.
Being the last award day night, I was a wee bit worried about being pished, but I think Jason and the lads have just took the heat right off me. You know, but it really is a privilege to be here and be part of honouring these three wonderful people. Their contribution to Scottish film and our industry will never be forgotten. But as filmmakers, they're as important as anybody, anywhere, who have came before or who will come after. And that's because they had the guts to make the films that nobody else would make, to tell the stories that would otherwise go untold. But it's the way they made those films, with humour, passion, and love. And there really is nobody like this dream team made up of this baldy wee ginger Scotsman, a constantly mumbling Englishman, and a lovely comrade who's the only one of the three with even a slight air of authority. But the only team I know who retire from working together and then a year later have their biggest hit and win the fucking Palme d'Or. Thing is, that film is also probably the most important film for this decade. But this is such an honour for me personally, because the only reason I'm here standing talking to y'all is because 13 years ago, these three people took a chance on me. They believed in me. I'm one of a few who owe their entire careers to these people. And I'm one of many to whom they've given the experiences of a lifetime by not just being part of these films, but in travelling the world with them and seeing places that I never thought I would. So on behalf of all those people, Ken, Rebecca, and Paul, thank you for believing in us.
Marty boy. Well, we've reached that time in the Scottish BAFTAs where people from afar start thinking that Hank Marvin is going to get a special award. They keep hearing Hank Marvin, man, Hank Marvin. I'm Hank. So, but this award goes to a very incredible trio who Martin and I have had the good fortune to work with. About 20 years ago, I heard Ken Loach doing a Q&A at a small film festival in Saint-Denis in Paris. And a woman in the audience, instead of asking a question, she said simply, "Mr. Loach, I can't believe that I'm in the same room as you. I just can't believe it." She said it in French with a Glasgow accent, so I understood everything. And Ken replied, well, we are in the same room, and if you put somebody on a pedestal, then you necessarily put yourself down. And that's not healthy. So let's just talk. Those words made an impact, and I'm sure it's an outlook which is shared by the wonderfully talented and industrious Paul Laverty and Rebecca O'Brien. So I'm going to try and present this award tonight without putting any of this heartful trio on a pedestal. And let's face it, there's in this game, there's a few pedestal hunters around, you know. Excuse me, mate, I think you're standing in my pedestal. No, your pedestal's down there, mate. Now, way back to your three-way, you muppet. Anyway, I don't include Martin Compston there, not at all. No, Martin Compston has never knowingly locked me out of his Big Winnie Bagel. A Big Winnie Bagel is something you're never likely to clap eyes on in a 16s film production. In fact, Rebecca O'Brien should insist that in the final credits it says no actor was overindulged in the making of this film. Nevertheless, as folk from Scotland and beyond will tell you, it is a unique and wonderful and rewarding experience to work with the 16 family. During the shoot, you will never fully appreciate what is woven into a Paul Laverty script because you don't get to see it. It's amazing. You get being drip-fed pages of the script and shooting in chronological order, it leads to many actors wandering about the location just wondering what's going on. And it's at that time that they tend to gravitate to the great world soul that is Davy Gilchrist. Only to be met with the big Davy Gilchrist smile. A smile that is wry, funny, warm, all-knowing, and giving away absolutely nothing. And then, of course, there's Ken himself. Ken, supporting every actor in every scene with this process he's developed, a process into which, along with the whole 16 family, goes a great deal of thought, preparation, and care. And of course, the proof of the pudding is in the eating. These films, to my mind, are the most significant films you could see in your life. They are generous to a fault. They give us bridges from our lives into the lives of others, into the lives of people struggling against oppression, fascism and imperialism, an insight into the lives of people struggling just to get through the day, just to survive, and an insight into the lives of people trying to make life better, to build a better society. They open our hearts and they make us challenge and ask at least the question, make us challenge the official version and ask the question, which side are you on? They're incredibly generous films, so this award comes not with any pedestal. It comes with the sincerest thanks, with enormous appreciation and a warm embrace. Let's look at some of the work.
Outstanding contribution to film.
Ken and Paul and Rebecca's contribution to the Scottish film industry is absolutely huge.
They've been working together for so long, it just seems like this perfect trinity, and it just works wonderfully.
A unique togetherness, a special bond.
They are to me a family for what they've gave me and what they do give you and how they treat you.
The bond that you have with the different cast and crew, which was really personable, not just you're there to do a job, it became a friendship and it became a family.
They're a humble group of people, very hardworking, honest, funny.
They're very collaborative, incredibly supportive. They're just amazing.
And you put all those people together, you know, you'll have a good time. So no dancing on tables trips.
Telling stories of our time through fiction is basically the way to tackle these issues that you can't tackle head on. So you do it obliquely, but you do it just as strongly through fiction. That's why I wanted to work with Ken, and that's what he's continued to do. He is spoiling for a fight and loves it, and I'm very happy to facilitate that fight.
If you make films about people's lives, politics is essential. If you're making a film about a family, what determines those lives? the starting point is, where do we live? What work do you do? How does that affect your relationship? Do you go on holiday? What did your parents do? What was your upbringing? They're all the result of political struggle over generations. So in a way, you can't walk away from it.
Tell me.
She's a junkie.
Oh, well, you might as well go up north and get her some fucking junk then, eh? You dance with a fucking devil, that's it, man. You're in the fucking gang. Ah, you are, Joe, you are. I can't believe how fucking naive you get to talk,
you know?
I'm
not being naive. I'm not going to call my tune. You've got to trust me, man.
Ken's brilliant. He calls himself a local apprentice sometimes, and I think that's very true. When we go away in jobs, Ken's somewhere between a colleague and a boss and a dad.
I mean, his energy level's double that of, you know, 90% of the crew. He's utterly committed to making the project.
Looking at Ken's films throughout the years and what he's trying to achieve, the message that he's trying to install in terms of what has been happening in society and across the world, he's clearly hit that note. He is a champion of the people, Ken Loach.
I am a Glaswegian, Pakistani teenager who supports Glasgow Rangers in a Catholic school.
I think Aethon Kiss was a fantastic story in that it helped people understand the issues the Muslim community face as well as the Catholic community, and bringing together in a relationship and in a form of love between these two characters.
I'm due to marry my first cousin, Yasmin, in 9 weeks. Honestly.
I don't believe you.
That set the basis for me as an actor to learn and to want to accomplish and achieve and really try to be involved in stories that had a social element to it as well.
Do you think she was going to jump, honestly?
She looked as if she was lying.
Shut up, Jamesy, man.
Yeah, lads, I've read about fucking the refugees, man. Fucking used and abused and then fucking get dumped anywhere.
You read about all the fucking time. You hear about them suffocating in trucks, fucking drowning on boats. Try to do them.
You're stealing your tickets and fucking up your football match.
When you work on a Ken Loach film, and this is also a tribute to Rebecca, in that they allow him to shoot the film in sequence and chronologically.
It's all about the performance and the words and being able to capture that moment.
And when you're performing, it almost makes you feel like you're living the story as opposed to just reading off something.
We just take a very open approach to searching for people. We just meet everyone in the right age group from the right geographical area, and that's a total luxury and a bit of a joy.
How many times have I done this?
Done what?
This.
It's just a gorgeous environment to work in. It comes from the top, it comes from Ken and Rebecca. Every film involves the local community. There's always this tremendous great goodwill towards them. Making that film at home, making that film with Ken, and making that film about, you know, Irish history, and it kind of really affected me as an actor and as a person.
I do solemnly swear that to the best of my ability, I will support and defend the government of the Irish Republic.
Everybody works very, very hard, but, you know, there's always a laugh to be had.
Fuck me. Sound the music.
There's just been a large number of occasions that have involved doubling over in laughter or total mischief.
Jesus Christ, what happened to you?
It's a long story, pal.
Oh, easy, eh?
Talking to people like Gary and William Rand, they would often tell me stories where Ken would be playing tricks. And he'd done that to me a few times. A few times I went to take a whiskey with John Henshaw and there was a double in it. So Ken, I'll be watching my drink tonight.
As a production company, you know, whether you're a day player or you're the lead part in the movie, you know, they'll treat you the same way and they'll make you feel as part of that production and as part of that film as you can be.
I'm not a shirker, a scrounger, a beggar, nor a thief. I'm not a national insurance number or blip on a screen.
What's it been like working with the guys at 16 Films? Life-changing?
It's 300 there. Okay, I reckon I'll leave you a couple of years ago here.
No, listen, you've done enough for us.
Liam, take the money.
We're not going to take
it. I'm going to go see McGowan, right? I'm telling him I'm out. Okay, I'm not doing the same, man. You know what that means? Aye? It means you've got to come after you two.
There's little snippets of my first job and from my first acting experience that will never go.
He's given me the platform to create a career for myself, better opportunities, and I've got a son now who's 8 years of age. He's wanting to direct. So it's had a knock-on effect throughout my family, and I must say I'm very, very thankful.
To be allowed to have been able to work in this style, which is so almost impossible anywhere else nowadays, it's been a real honour and privilege to be asked back to be able to do it.
They're the calmest, sweetest, most unassuming people, you know, and I think that comes from the impulse being all about the work. The impulse really is all about the work and about the types of films that they're trying to make. But it's done in such a gentle way, yet the films are so provocative.
If we as human beings are touched by this story, you know, and we do that well, then you've maybe got a chance of touching other people. That's what gives you the motor to actually do the damn thing, because there's something inside you that burns to do it.
I hope you guys go on to do so much more. I, Daniel Blake, Pam Dore, what can we say? Congratulations.
It was amazing working with you guys. 11 years ago now, I think it is. So congratulations again from everybody in Cork. lots of love.
A massive congratulations to Ken, Paul and Rebecca for this so utterly deserved award this evening.
Important thing to remember, pudding is the enemy of creativity. Anybody who's worked with us will understand that. I'd also, the other thing, this is just ridiculous. Thank you so much, BAFTA Scotland. You just know where, you know what makes sense. That's really sweet. That's lovely to see that. Just so many memories coming of all these moments. Can I just, I think most of the people in this room have worked with us, so, you know, give yourselves a round of applause. And I'm really sorry that there's a lot of people who aren't here. There weren't enough seats. But Ken is absent, but he did actually give me a message. I'm trying to make it work here. Oh, my God.
Ah,
good. So, he's not here. And he's a bit pissed off about it, and he was trying to find a way to get up here, but he couldn't make it. And anyway, this is a message from Ken. Well, this is really shocking, by the way. What can I say? He's adopting the language. I wouldn't have missed this for anything. As we footballers say, I'm gutted, sick as a parrot. Annoyingly, I have to go for an MOT, and there's a queue at the garage. So that's my excuse. Feeble, I know. Anyway, as I realized long ago, the team is so well organized, it plays brilliantly, whatever the circumstances. With Davey as the midfield general, spraying passes around the pitch, how can we ever go wrong? Is there a big silver cup to hold aloft tonight? There ought to be, and a medal for each and every member in the gang. You have all been and are a wonderful, talented, loyal, and hilarious group of friends. I daren't list all the names. There have been a few changes over the years, but everyone is remembered with affection and everyone has made a special and individual contribution. Whatever we've done together. And as they say, there's no I in the team. I don't know if Pete Murphy is there tonight.
Yes.
He is. But I hope he's got his shorts on. They always seem to be in my eye line. David Gilchrist and Michael Queen are the best double act since Morecambe and Wise. And Fergus's entire team always play a blinder, with a special mention to the absent Bobby G. We share a secret. Carleen and Caroline always find the most beautiful, brilliant people for us to film. So many memories and so many good comrades. And of course, I haven't read this before, the person reading this has made it all possible. The Peebles answer to Joan of Arc and Mother Teresa in one. I am from Peebles, despite the accent. Finally, if by any chance there's a wee baldy cunt trying to look anonymous. Sorry, it's past the watcher. He's the one to blame for refusing to give an inoffensive pensioner a bit of peace and quiet. Please send photographic evidence of any misbehaviour as it happens, and let's stick around a bit longer, shall we? We need to keep our motto alive. Just one more time. All that time.
After seeing that wonderful farmer deliver that cow and make it come alive after 8 minutes, I think making films is really a doddle, you know. So should we have a sense of perspective, I think, about it all. Yeah. Actually, I know, Edith, thanks for tonight. To keep that going for an hour and a half was brilliant. Thank you. We're actually totally knocked out with these kind words. Thank you very much. In fact, we've actually got a seat, one empty seat there. And if I'd known that, Edith, we might have invited someone who's helped us very recently, the Secretary of State for the DWP, Mr. Damien Green, who gave us great support by denouncing our film in Parliament without watching it. So thank you.
You've seen the trailer.
Actually, it gets better because he said, I've seen the trailers. There is only one, but he didn't obviously realise it was the same one he was watching again and again. So thank you. Anyway, table number 6 and table 15 is just full of people who have helped us along the way, who have made these films, and in front of the camera and behind the camera. And it really is, this prize is actually a recognition of collaboration, the art of filmmaking. Fellow dreamers, thank you very much.
On my radio show on Wednesday, and he was genuinely gutted that he wasn't going to be able to make it tonight, but he was so thrilled and genuinely touched and honoured that that they'd been recognised, and particularly when this film is so important that it's been recognised right now. For those of you who've seen it, the scene in the food bank was based on a real scene and event that Paul had been told about that someone witnessed right here in Glasgow. So if you take anything away from tonight, is go and see that film and just tell people how important it is and how important their films are, because the great news from tonight is that they might do another one, which is great. From spending like half an hour with Ken Loach, I felt like the most special person in the world as well. It was He's magical. There's just something incredible about the man. So it's great to see them recognised tonight. Right then, there you have it. 2016, congratulations to all the nominees and winners. Thank you to all the presenters and partners and to you all for attending, to you watching at home. Bye-bye. And supporting excellence in the art form of the moving image. I've been Edith Bowman, wishing you a very good night. Thank you very much.